May I come in, sir?
Yes, come in.
Morning, sir.
Good morning.
Good morning, ma'am.
Take your seat. Bharat Soni.
Yes, sir.
Tell us something about you.
Sir, I was born and brought up in Sujangad, which comes under the district Churu of Rajasthan. I did my schooling from Sujangad, and after intermediate, I enrolled myself in Bikaner University and did BCom. And after BCom, I thought that I have to do something in my life. So therefore, I thought that I should enroll in some professional course. So I enrolled myself in Delhi University, and I completed my LLB in 2018. In 2017, I realized that that I should set for a civil service examination. And in 2017, I set, but I could not clear prelims. In 2018, I was able to clear prelims and mains, and that's why I'm here.
What is so special about the civil services that you want to join?
So in 2017, when I realized that that you have to put your best for preparing this examination, then I think that there is a sort of challenge. And I also saw that there is a diversity in this profession, because as I completed my law, so I can work as a legal advisor in some company, or I can start my practice. But I thought that in civil services, there is a diversity of job. So I thought that I should apply for that, and there is a sense of satisfaction also. And my family also supported my decision. That's why I...
How is the knowledge of law, and you are a student of commerce also?
Yes, sir.
Are going to help you in the discharge of your duties as a civil servant?
Definitely, sir, because as I have some knowledge regarding the accountancies and the income tax. Therefore, it would help me if I join Indian Administrative Service or other civil services, because I came to know about the various methods of bookkeeping. And I also have knowledge of law, so that would help me to solve the disputes which has legal issues. So definitely, sir, I believe that understanding of law definitely help in administrative services.
Have you heard of PPP?
EPP.
PPP. Triple P.
Sir, public-private partnership.
What is it?
Sir, this public-private partnership model has been emphasized more on after 1991, when we started the LPG reforms. So in the public-private partnership, the private companies invest on the plans made by the government. And they participated in the venture which is started by the government. Mainly in the PPP partnership model, the 51 stakes are mainly taken by the government, and the 49 by the private sector. So it will increase and infuse the efficiency in the functioning of the project with related to infrastructure development.
Why should government encourage this model?
So because after 1991, our emphasis was more on toward governance. So it is also saying that government should emphasize more on governance rather than business. So therefore, this new public management which has started in America, and then we also we can observe this in India. Therefore, I think the government strive to increase the participation of the private sector, by which the capital can be infused in the market, or the infrastructure development can be boosted up.
Can you name some models under PPP?
Yes, sir.
Tell me.
Sir, there was one model, engineering procurement and construction.
In this, EPC, you think is a PPP model?
So it comes under the PPP model, I think. So, but I'm not sure. But
okay.
And now they are build, operate, transfer model, BOT, in which the private companies build a particular infrastructure project.
Okay.
And then they operate it for a particular period of time.
Mm-hmm.
And when they cover their cost, mm-hmm. then they'll again send that to the government. And I think there's last year they have also introduced this HAM, hybrid annuity model.
Okay. Have you heard of Swiss Chalet method?
Yes, sir. I have read about it.
What is that model, Swiss Challenge?
Yes, sir. In the Swiss challenge model, I think it is the private sector which has to come with a plan, and the government will say government will encourage the private sector to come with a plan, and the government will pay them initial cost of the particular project which is deliberated by the private sector, and the government will announce that plan through the newspaper or publicized it, and then the other private companies can also come and they can say that with low cost we can also build that. So it will increase the competitiveness between the private sector.
Has this model been tried anywhere in the country?
Sir, I can estimate if you allow.
Tell me.
I think in Madhya Pradesh, I think Habibullah Metro, Habibullah Railway Station, I think they tried it, but I'm not sure.
Okay, thank you.
Thank you, sir.
You are from Chudu.
Yes, sir.
What about sex ratio of Chudu?
Sir, as Chudu comes under the Shekhawati region of Rajasthan, so there was some incidents with regarding to the female fertilizers in the Chudu. But overall, if we see the Chudu's performance within the Shekhawati region, it is far better, because now the sex ratio in Chudu is 948 per 1000.
Okay. Now, I have heard about some education institutions which have been opened in Chudu areas, and that is particularly for girls students. Girl students for their education. Am I true?
Sir, there are various institutions in Chudu. I came from Sujangad,
yeah,
which comes under the Chudu district. Mm-hmm. So there is one big businessman in Sujangad, Nirmal Di Sethia.
Mm-hmm.
He stays in London. He built one Sonadevi Sethia college especially for the girls.
Okay.
And there is also various other institution, not for girls but co-ed institution. The government medical college has also been built last year.
Mm-hmm.
So
through these education institutions, whether the girls of Churus, they have been benefited or not?
So definitely they have benefited,
mm-hmm,
from that institution, as we have seen that if we see the education ratio, literacy ratio, especially in Rajasthan, it's 67%. Where the woman is 53% and man is 80%. So there is a large variation. But in Chudu, they are performing well due to the fact that the family also now try to emphasize more on providing girls to the education.
Mm-hmm.
And therefore, we have seen that in the last year, Rajasthan Judicial Service Examination, it was historical that 120 RJs got selected. Out of that, 70 were girls and many were from Chudu. So that show that how the women are performing there in field of education and in sports.
Okay. And what about politics? In the field of politics, do you have any women leaders from Chudu?
Yes, sir. We have. It's a combination of sports plus politics. Krishna Punya. She won this year election from Rajgarh,
okay,
which comes under the Chudu.
And what about Sala, sir? Where it is located?
Sir, it is 13 kilometers away from my...
Have you visited there?
Yes, sir. So many.
What is its significance?
So its significance is that the Mohandasji who built that temple, it was established way back before 150 years ago.
Hmm.
And now it's famous for the Balaji, Salasar Balaji. And the people from the Punjab, Haryana and Rajasthan visited there every year. And it also boosted the tourism sector in the Sujangad area. And
generally Balaji stands for Vishnu. What about Salasar Balaji?
Sir, beg your pardon, sir?
No, generally, the term that is Balaji.
Yes, sir.
It is for Vishnu, God Vishnu. What about Salasar Balaji?
Sir,
it is Vishnu temple?
There is no Vishnu temple as I have seen.
Hmm.
But there is a Balaji temple there.
Balaji means which God?
Hanumanji, sir.
Hanumanji.
Yes, sir.
And what about Khatu Shyam?
Sir,
why Shyam is known as Khatu there?
Sir, I think, I don't know exactly, but I think people locate the god with the name of the region. So we have a Mehndipur Balaji. So Mehndipur is an area in Alwar.
Mm-hmm.
So Khatu is an area in Sikar district of Rajasthan.
Mm-hmm.
And Salasar is also an area in Sujangad.
Mm-hmm.
So I think they locate the name with the region.
You have never tried to analyze this.
Yes, sir.
It is just your guess.
Yes, sir, that's my only guess.
Achha, no problem. Suppose, I'm talking about United Nations.
Yes, sir.
If it takes some decision,
yes, sir,
whether it is mandatory or not.
Sir, as we have be a part of United Nations, in international law, there is nothing called mandatory or obligatory.
Hmm.
There is always a persuasive values of the resolution passed by the United Nations.
Mm-hmm.
As in a participant in that organization, we always obliged to follow that resolutions. But if we term legal, if we say legally, there is no sort of obligation on us.
Let's just tell me about two weaknesses of United Nations.
So two?
Weaknesses. Two limitations.
Yes, sir. The first and foremost is because there is a sort of inequality in the functioning of United Nations.
And another?
And which also reveals the democratic deficit in the United Nations. And second thing, I think, sir, there is a less participation of women in the United Nations.
Thank
you, sir.
Bharat.
Yes, sir.
I was going through your detailed application form and I came across this strange thing, engaged with biographical work.
Yes, sir.
What kind of a hobby, what kind of interest is it?
Sir, I was not fond of reading during my BCom examination, during the BCom period. But when I came to Delhi, I enrolled myself in Delhi University. So the teachers, I was lucky that I got a senior teacher there. So they always pushed us to read something which you want, which you like. So in my libraries, there are the various biographies of the legal luminaries. The first biography which I read was of Nani Palkhiwala, the courtroom genius. So there, the engagement was, I engrossed myself in the life and time of Nani Palkhiwala. And I got motivated from his life. Therefore, I started reading various other biographies as well. So engagement means it's a source of inspiration which I take from their life.
Okay. A similar kind of an interest or hobby you have is while you travel, you talk with strangers.
Yes.
Tell me, if we compare, say, a train, a conventional train with a train like Shatabdi or a metro, what are the structural changes in these two coaches? In which the conventional railway coach allow you to break conversation with strangers, while in metro or in a plane or in a Shatabdi train, it is difficult.
So I traveled usually in general bogies. So there the people hardly have these smartphones. So they are they have plenty of time. They can discuss with anyone. You should be eager to discuss with them. But as I traveled in metro a lot, I find that in metropolitan cities, there's a sort of the people are very much engrossed in their self. They will engross.
Do you
in
also realize that the sitting structure is such that you cannot break conversation with your fellow travelers?
So in general bogies, usually we stand and travel because there's so much rush in the trains. But I think the people are more eager to discuss.
There's a similar. It is said that if you do conversation with strangers,
yes,
you break your prejudices, right?
Yes, sir.
There is a human library project. What is human library?
Exactly, sir. I'm not able to recollect now. Human library.
In US, there is a US shutdown going on.
Yes, sir.
What is US shutdown and why is it there?
Sir, as we all know that the US government is based on presidential form of government. So there is a strict separation of power between the executive, which is headed by the president, and the legislature, Congress and the Senate. Now, Mr. Trump, he is trying to get some money from the House to build a wall in the Mexican border. The House is not sanctioning that money, $5.7 billion he wants. And now, is it the prerogative of the president that in opposition he can shut down the functioning of the government? Therefore, in opposition of a Congress, Mr. Trump has gave a decision to shut down the functioning
since
of the
study
government.
Law and you're saying it with confidence that it has to do with the presidential form of government.
Yes,
so
sir.
I think you're pretty sure that in our country where we don't follow presidential form of government,
yes,
such a logjam between an executive and a legislature is,
yes,
generally not possible.
Yes, sir.
But we see the same happening in the Brexit, which is not following the presidential form of government.
Yes, sir.
Why is it so?
Sir, in Brexit, I think the scenario is different. Because in Brexit...
But again, there is a problem with the executive, the executive head and the legislature.
Yes, sir.
They are not agreeing on a particular direction.
Yes, sir. In Britain, sir, there is no such strict separation of power. Because there is a sort of intermobility between the executive and legislature.
That is what the case with India
is. Yes, sir. And in Brexit, especially both the Tory party and the Labour party, they are not agreeing with the Theresa May's deal. So they are not opposing the moves of the executive. They are saying that we are not agree to this deal. You have to make some amendment in the deal by which we can have a safe exit from the Britain. So there is a sort of conflict ongoing between the Theresa May's deal and the members of the both the Tory and Labour Party.
Since you study law,
yes, sir,
and you know we are a sovereign nation. You yes, just sir. Talked about United Nations again, the sovereignty. So India is sovereign, fine. But what in India is sovereign? You're getting my point. As a nation, we are sovereign.
Yes,
but
sir.
Where lies our sovereignty?
So the parliament is sovereign.
Are you sure in our system, parliament is sovereign?
Sir, there is a supremacy of a constitution.
Constitution is sovereign?
Sir, constitution is sovereign in India.
Where does the constitution drives its sovereignty from?
Sir, from the people.
So, people are sovereign?
Yes, sir, definitely.
Tell me, people are sovereign, parliament is sovereign, constitution is sovereign?
Sir, there is no, if I say the, if I want to give preferences, then the people are sovereign because we the people of India as the preamble states from where we derive the power.
But then it leads to mobocracy and mob lynchings.
No, sir. The fact is when we say we the people of India, it means that peoples have reposed their confidence on the institutions created by the constitution. Like the parliament is one of the institutions. Judiciary is one of the institutions. Therefore, there is no... The mobocracy is there where there is no rule of law. But in India, we have a rule of law. And we function according to the norms of the constitution. So therefore, I don't believe that that there is a sort of mobocracy or any sort of this sort of functions exist in India.
Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you, ma'am.
Bharat.
Yes, ma'am.
You are a student of law?
Yes,
what
ma'am.
What is voluntary non-fit injuria?
Yes, ma'am. This voluntary non-fit injuria is a common principles of the common law system, which states that if a person agree to run the risk, then he should bear that risk.
Okay. And nobody will be liable for that.
Yes. And he cannot take excuse of others' default. He cannot take that excuse. For example, ma'am, if I agree that I will... I will run on that. I will go in the highways in the night, and I will cross the road without checking that from where the car is coming. So I am running the risk on my own. So I should not take that responsibility.
Okay. What is damnum sine injuria?
Yes, sir, ma'am. Damnum sine injuria is also a principle of a common law system. It says that damages without the infringement of a right. And for example, if you are running a school and your competitor also established a new school and you are running the losses from that competition, so you cannot say that I got damages and because there is no infringement of your rights.
There is a very famous case for this.
Yes, ma'am. There is a Gloucester Grammar School case.
Very good. Okay, you are also a student of commerce.
Yes, ma'am.
There is a new board which is coming up, Insolvency Board.
Yes, ma'am.
Why do we need it?
Ma'am, as we all know, to have a strong economic growth in the country, we have to provide an ease of exit. Because as we have seen in the past, and as our former chief economic advisor, Arvind Subramanian, has said that India, there is a sort of chakra view, where the company can start their business, but it's very hard to exit. Especially those companies which are declared themselves insolvent and bankrupt. So this IBC code will provide the ease of exit from the market.
Who will be the operators of this board? Like who will be the agents? CAs?
No, ma'am. They are the insolvents. They are the insolvency professionals, and there would be also tribunals, debt recovery tribunals, and CLAT for the companies, and debt recovery tribunals for the private individuals and the public-private partnerships.
Apart from mediation, what are the other ways where a resolution of dispute or conflict can be held?
Yes, ma'am. There are the various mechanisms comes under the ADR, which are negotiation, mediation, arbitration, conciliation, and Lok Adalats.
Okay. Which one do you prefer, the most amicable?
Ma'am, I prefer Lok Adalats.
Reason?
Ma'am, the reason is in Lok Adalat, there is a sanction of the law because the judge will sit there and he will conduct the mediation sessions. What happened normally in the mediation sessions, that the private parties come together and there's a private mediator. but sometimes they withdraw themselves because they come to the decision, but they withdraw themselves. But in Lok Adalat, they show that there's an authority of the law. So they always keep this thing in mind while arriving at the settlement.
Okay, let's take a situation. You have a subordinate, you got selected.
Yes, ma'am.
And you are posted in a district.
Yes, ma'am.
And a subordinate comes to you in your district and he says that he has killed his daughter. He has already 3 daughters and now he got 4th daughter, infanticide. He indulged in, and this is very common in his community. And he said that because he want to raise his 3 daughters in a very effective manner and he cannot afford to have 4th daughter, and so he killed that child.
Yes, ma'am.
And he is telling you in very good faith, trusting you.
Yes, ma'am.
So what do you do now?
Ma'am, as we all know, that killing someone is a culpable homicide. Therefore, whether he did that in a good motive or a bad motive, law will not consider that. As an administrator, it's my utmost duty that I should uphold the rule of the law. So I will definitely charge him again under the culpable homicide or under the relevant provision of the IPC.
And what about the trust he is posing in you?
Ma'am, the trust which he is posing on me, I personally believe that as he is disclosing all the facts, then the court will undertake all the aggravating and mitigating circumstances of that particular case. But as an administrator, it's my duty that I should penalize him for his conduct.
Okay, Bharat.
Yes, sir.
What is nuclear triad? Are you aware of this term?
Yes, sir.
Okay, what is that?
So nuclear triad means when we have a nuclear energy, nuclear power, and we can use that nuclear power from land, from air, and from sea. So this INS Ariane which we have built, it comes under the doctrine of nuclear triad, where we can have that sort of mechanism where we can use our power and wherewithal from the 3 field which I had mentioned, sir.
Okay, so what is there in INS Ariane which allow the nuclear warhead to go to the enemy territory?
I am not the nitty-gritty of the INS Ariane, but I think there's a nuclear submarine. It's a nuclear submarine which will provide the launching facility for the nuclear missile.
What do you mean by altruistic surrogacy?
Yes, sir. Sir, this altruistic surrogacy concept was introduced in a recent ART reproductive technology bill, where we have seen that in the past, due to the commercial surrogacy.
It is ART bill or surrogacy regulation bill?
It's a surrogacy regulation bill.
Okay.
Surrogacy regulation bill 2016, I'm not sure, but 2016, I think. In that, they are prohibiting the commercial surrogacy. And in altruistic surrogacy, they will see that the surrogacy is allowed, but it should be based on the faith. And it should be based on some altruistic terms, like a surrogate mother should be a relative of that person who want to have a surrogate child.
Which kind of relation? Is it blood relation or any relation it would be?
Sir, I'm not sure about that, but I think it must be close relatives for that person.
So my friend can give surrogacy services to me?
Sir, but that must be in your family, so it must be blood relation, I think. Then.
Okay. Do you know about COP24?
In Katowice, which they have. Yes, sir. After the Paris Agreement, as we have seen that USA has withdrawn from the Paris Treaty. In Katowice, Poland, all the countries solemnly resolved that now we will go ahead with our Paris deal, and those the INDC which all the countries has fixed, they will strive to achieve that.
Okay, what is differential responsibility in terms of this climate change and the COP things?
Yes, sir. In Warsaw Convention, this term, that common but differential responsibility concept was emanated, where the country, especially the poor developing and undeveloped developing countries stated that due to the fact that the developed country has destroyed and obliterated the environment in the last 100 years, and due to the fact that they were the imperial and colonial power,
okay.
Therefore it's now their time.
Recently, this Section 377 of IPC, it has been decriminalized. So, don't you think this is, like cultural morality is on a back foot now?
Sir, I think this section 377 was diluted, and this cultural morality will yield in the front of constitutional morality. Because in constitutional morality, we speaks of equality, we speaks of fraternity. Therefore, section 377 somewhat prohibited the consensual relationship, homosexual relationship. Therefore, I think it does not stand with the provisions of the constitution. Therefore, it has to go. And what the Supreme Court stated that the constitutional morality will prevail over the social morality.
Okay. And what is blockchain technology?
Yes, sir. In the blockchain technology, they are the blocks. It's a form of ledger where there is a connected blocks. And so there will be a less human intervention in it. And it will bring transparency and accountability within the system.
Okay, fine. So,
should I call you Bharat or Bharat?
Sir, Bharat, sir.
You are Bharat.
Yes, sir.
Good. Bharat, imagine a situation where you are working as Principal Secretary Tourism.
Yes, sir.
Government of Rajasthan. And I am a foreign guest, a foreign dignitary rather. I come on a visit to your state. And I call on you and I express my desire to go to Haldi Ghati.
Yes, sir.
So, and you are accompanying me as a tourist guide also. So, what will you show me in Haldi Ghati and what will you tell me about the importance of Haldi Ghati?
So I will first of all speak about the historical facets which is related with the Haldi Ghati. And I will detail you about the battle which was fought between the Mahan.
You tell me. Imagine I am your guest.
Okay, sir.
Now you tell me.
Okay, sir. Sir, as you know, this Haldi Ghati is famous for its historical glory because the battle of Haldi Ghati were fought between the Mughal ruler Akbar and the Maharana Pratap. Therefore, this place is famous for its bravery. This place is famous for valor, and it comes into the Chittorgarh area. Therefore, I will also go with you to the Chittorgarh fort and Vijay Stambh. You can also see the Vijay Stambh there. So that is what I.
Any other thing which you would like to share with me? Any other importance of Haldi Ghati apart from Battle of Haldi Ghati?
So I have not visited there. This is only what I read.
Okay.
So this is what I can.
Thank you, Bharat. Your interview is over.
Thank you, sir. Thank you, ma'am.
Welcome, sir.
Haan, Bharat, sit.
Thank you, sir.
So, what is your assessment of the interview?
So it was. I think I am a hero because the scene is just like that. Okay. Glamour.
We are extremely happy with your performance.
Thank you, sir.
Wonderful personality.
Thank you, sir.
And you attempted all questions very well, answered in a most satisfying manner.
Thank you, sir.
And we remained very calm and composed while answering. That is a big quality. You have a patience to listen to questions and then to respond. Honesty of purpose is there. So all good qualities which is required from a civil servant, you have all those qualities.
Yeah, thank you, sir.
When is your interview?
So 15th of Feb.
15th of Feb. One or two things which I thought we should tell you.
Yes, sir.
Is that you try to maintain eye contact. Slightly you are not sitting straight.
Okay, sir.
Sitting posture mein you can work on it. Because hum logo ko yahan se dekh ke aisa lag raha hai ki as if you're leaning
jhuke hue
ho. I don't know whether you're doing it deliberately. Aisa ho gaya hai.
Sir, I think I have to work on that.
Thoda sa kar lo. I mean,
हो सकता है इस ब्लेजर की वजह से लग रहा हो या वास्तव में ऐसे थोड़ा सा झुक के बैठे हुए हैं. I don't know. I'm not sure.
It's fine, sir. Krishna, we must be having. I mean,
आपके पास तो बहुत सारे black ब्लेजर्स होंगे तो.
Habit of किया सर ये.
मूड कोट्स में नहीं जाते थे.
सर मूड नहीं किया था सर मैंने.
अच्छा किया नहीं था.
Otherwise, you are all fit candidate to be chosen. Absolutely, If your written marks are good, then you will get fantastic marks in the interview.
Thank you, sir.
You have no doubt. Any questions from your side?
Sir, I want to know, sir, that if I came in a room, then how should I greet? Because in greeting...
The way you greeted, what did you find wrong?
No, I should say some, first of all, to the chairman.
You should address chairman.
Okay.
Obviously, address chair first, and then if there is a women member, then rest of the.
Okay, sir.
Okay. Usually, that is the way. Entry karte samay, wahin se loudly take permission so that everybody gets your attention.
Yes, ma'am.
Then you come yahan pe straight khade hokar aap greet kijiye isi order mein. First the chairman, then the women member, then other members. ठीक है और उसके बाद wait for you to be asked to sit down or ask permission to sit down. That's the usual way.
चलो all the best.
So और कोई अगर
बस ठीक है you're doing perfect. ज़्यादा suggestion
लोगे गर्बन
all the best. You're almost there. Wish you all the
best.
Thank
you sir.